Good afternoon, everybody. Brett here. Wanted to do a overview of the TrendSpider charting software and how I use it. A really broad overview. I'll be making a few videos later on, going into a little bit of a deeper dive, but I'm such a huge fan of the system and the functionality that I wanted to put some information out there. So TrendSpider, of course, is known for their automated technical analysis. It really starts with their automated trend lines, helping traders, new traders, etc., really kind of narrow down some of those important areas of confluence. Different things like automated Fibonacci, automated candlestick patterns, which our very own Jeremy Newsom has his own patterns in there as well. Hoping they're going to be adding some more here soon, but you never know. This is a great, I like to use this for back trading. They have their heat maps, which cover different areas of support and resistance based on their own algorithm, based on the number of different trend lines, to really help find different areas of that, again, support resistance. Their events tab here, which covers analyst recommendations of buy, things like that, I believe for US stocks only. One of the huge features that I love is their multi-time frame analysis. And so how I like to use this, if I'm on a lower time frame and I want to know where things are at on the daily chart, I can go in here to multi-time frame analysis. I'm on the 65-minute chart. I can select, you know, whichever indicator or whichever, you know, what have you, I want to see on the daily chart. So in this case, I have my EMA clouds up, the 8 and 21 and the 34 and 50 on the daily itself. So while I'm operating on the 65-minute chart, I can see exactly where the daily chart is at. You can also do that for RSI, for instance. This dotted line would be the RSI on the daily chart. And you can use that for any time frame. I've used it for day trading before. If I'm on the 5-minute and I want to see where things are at on the 15-minute, for example, I can do the same thing there. So I'm a big fan of that multi-time frame analysis. Moving through this here, their script building platform is super easy. I love using scripts because it's not only for the scanning software, you can set alerts off of it and use it for their backtesting feature. So we're all familiar with the MoMo strategy, right? The 821 cross, price closing above the 105 EMA. So I have that script built. So if I want to, for instance, scan my own personal watch list, or if I wanted to go, maybe go to a different index, you know, the Russell, S&P, I could scan specifically by sector if I'd like. Whatever you're looking for, really this system can do. If I wanted to create an alert off of this, for instance, if I create alert multi-factor, you know, I can go right in here, plug my script in, the 8 and 21, select that, my time period, and when that cross happens, of course, I will get that alert. The other thing that's interesting about their alerts is you can create alerts off of trend lines or support resistance levels. So I have a trend line drawn on the SPY here. And so for instance, if we're making a move up and I want to know when does price come within this area, I can simply create an alert and I can either select breakthrough, touch, bounce, or all three, which is my preference, the different sensitivity level, and whatever time frame that you want to be notified by, down to the 10 minutes, the number of days before the alert expires, etc. And so I'll get a notification, not only on the charting software, but on my cell phone as well, a quick text message, hey, your alert went off, you know, take action. So I'm a big fan of that. Their strategy tester, which I have not played around this a whole heck of a lot yet, but any of those scripts that you build or anything that you want to try out, you can plug in here, have your exit condition and test on whichever stock that you're looking at. Of course, they have their customized annotation tools, their dynamic watch list, so you can create alerts off the watch list, you can scan the watch list. And with the market scanner too, it comes with a whole bunch of pre-built scans. And so it's, if you're looking for like a MACD golden cross or a bearish cross or RSI breakdown, breakout, whatever you're looking for, they have a lot of pre-built ones in there. And you can save those scripts as well, and really helps make things really easy as you're creating them. So one last thing I wanted to cover, and I'll go into it a little further in a different video, is their raindrop charts. So I'm a huge fan of these raindrop charts in certain situations because they're not based on price, they're based on volume. And what I mean by that is if you zoom in fairly closely, you can see each raindrop has a line on the left, a line on the right, and that represents half of the period. So right now we're on the daily chart. And so the left side shows me the VWAP for the first half of the period, and the right side shows me the VWAP for the second half. and this is the concentration of volume within that area. And so basically what it's telling me is, hey, you have your price chart, you know, where was the volume concentration on that day? And I like to look at it for breakouts. You know, we had one recently, I believe, I want to say it was JMIA. I think it was this candle here where we had a breakout. But if you want to know how strong it was, you could drop to a raindrop chart. And I can see within that raindrop chart, it was right here. So this candle, I'm going to highlight this real quick. This candle, you can see the left side and the right side. The last half of the day, the large volume concentration, which is basically a volume profile of the candle that day, above this support resistance level here. So if you're looking at just the candle itself, you know, it looks good, but it does look like a bit of an indecision candle. But if you do look at the raindrop chart, you can certainly see where a majority of the volume was concentrated at. As for right now, that's pretty much all I have for this video. Again, just a high level overview of TrendSpider, why I'm a fan of them, and the number of different things that you can do with them. I know they've got some great new features coming as well. A mobile version is on the way for iOS and Android. I believe they're working on broker integration as well, where the data feed for TrendSpider will come to you from whatever broker that you're integrated with. I don't know which brokers it'll be, but from what from the CEO said, should be the majority of the main brokers. So if you do have any questions, please feel free to reach out to me through Slack. Happy to answer anything that I can. And again, I will be doing some subsequent videos on exactly how I use this software as a whole. Thanks, everybody.